and Sue, how do you do?
Well, we saw, Ralph and Sue, how do you do? Yeah, we saw that last year in the finale. Sue Dearborn, we saw that. Yeah. We saw the Dearborn file, and we're going to pursue that. I can't say too much about it, but, you know, look, that's a thing. Like, that's now a thing that we're finally doing. And that's probably the number one question that I got since I started playing this character was, well, what about Sue? What about Sue? What about Sue? And, you know, we knew when we started in season four with Ralph, if things go well, if he fits into the team, if it all works and all of that, all roads lead to Sue Dibny. Sue Dearborn first, but then Sue Dibny.
I made this mistake.
Yeah, and that's just something that I've been excited about. But I like that we did not put that in any earlier than we're putting it in now. I really, really do. Because I think it would have been too soon. Because he's got to get ready for that. He's got to mature for that. And now he's there. He's ready for that. He's ready for love.
I mean, was it great seeing you and Sherlock kind of bounce off each other in terms of technical skills in the season?
Yeah, that you mean last year?
Yeah, last year.
I really, really enjoyed doing that. I mean, any chance I get to work with Tom is amazing because I learn a lot as an actor because his instincts are so good and his abilities are so good. I think we all know that with the 5 billion characters that he plays on the show. And the fun thing about working with Tom is he's so quick and he's so witty, and especially with that character, that you just have to keep up, you know? And I like that because I love doing some improv. I love just trying to keep up with that stuff. So that was super fun for me. I love those characters together. And I also love how that kind of became what it became at the end of the season, like mutually endearing
thing. He kind of evolved over the course of the season. Like, he was his own capable protector.
Yeah.
You know, to the point where even he was like, really sure he
Well, that was the thing. I mean, he figured everything out last year with Vaughn and all that was going on with the dagger and all of that, you know? So I really enjoyed that being kind of where it came full circle and him seeing something that Sherlock didn't see. You know, I like that a lot. And I'm excited that we got there with that because I love the detective aspect of the character. Super fun.
Ralph's relationship and friendship with Sisko, is that affected now since Sisko basically has given up his powers and it seems like he left Star Labs for a while? Is that a strain on the friendship? Can you talk about that?
You know, I don't think it's a strain on the friendship in the sense that we haven't gotten to shoot to filming and digging into that too much. Obviously, we've done some stuff there, but we haven't specifically gotten to too much of that yet, but we will. But, from Ralph's standpoint, I think he said last year, I think he said this to Killer Frost, where, people should have a choice if they want to take that or not, if they want to participate in being a metahuman or not. I believe he said people should have the choice. And so I think for him, if his friend is happy and his friend feels it's the right choice for him, he supports that. Like, I don't think that would be a black mark on their friendship or anything like that. You know, they really bonded last year a lot, and those scenes were really, really fun to shoot and really fun stuff to do with those two guys together. And I think what's funny about Ralph and Sisko is they're so different in so many ways, but they have a tremendous amount in common, actually, just in terms of the way they kind of deal with things with humor and sarcasm and all of that, and it's really fun to put them together. What else?
Is Ralph going to get a new wingman now that Sherlock is gone in his quest for love?
He is, and I can't say too much about it. Yeah. He is. I can't say too much more about that, but that's going to be a thing. But he's also going to be more independent this year than he's ever been. In the sense of, I'm going to go solve whatever I'm going to solve. I'm going to go figure this out, but yes, there is going to be a wingman situation.
I feel like your character's grown so much throughout each season he's been in, so are we going to get to see maybe Ralph Dibny the leader at some point?
You know, I don't know. Maybe on a long enough timeline, that's above my pay grade. I mean, the one thing that I can tell you is I love the progression of that. I had a ball playing this guy in season four and doing, the Tex Avery version of him and the total wacky walking Looney Tunes. And I love still doing that stuff when those elements come in, when he's out in the field or whatever. But I love the growth and progression from season four to the end of season four. And, at the end of season four, when he died and the Thinker took him and then when he came back, look, that obviously changed him. That changed the guy tremendously. So that allowed us in season five to start him where he was, a little more mature, and then even grow him throughout season five. And we're going to see more of that now because he's going to be challenged by crisis. It's going to happen. The crossover is going to challenge everybody tremendously. And everybody in their own way. But Ralph is going to be particularly affected by what might take place during crisis. And that's going to change him even further. And then and the introduction of Sue, which we'll get to at some point. You got to change when that happens, Sue. You got to evolve when that happens, Sue.
Visually and in costume wise.
Sorry, say again.
Visually and costume wise, Ralph has had a progression as well. Will we see anything different in the new season?
In terms of how his costume looks?
Yeah.
You know, we haven't talked about a redesign. I mean, season 4, we started with. Some people hated it. I loved it. I loved the onesie, the old blue thing. Like, I loved it. And then we got, like, the suit in episode 11 that year. And last year we had the suit. We haven't talked about a redesign. I think if that happens, that's after Crisis, I think, if anything like that happens. Because, again, that's going to be a tremendous game changer in terms of how the geography and how all of this Arrowverse world looks. I know people say this kind of stuff a lot, but it is going to change. It's going to change things forever. There's no doubt about it. Nothing's going to be the same after Crisis.